Without the support of our customers, you, the residents of Barmoor, this entrance would never have been reconnected to the castle, and a very special couple have agreed to cut the ribbon once the gates have been blessed. George and Hazel Talbot were the very first customers to purchase a holiday home here at Barmoor 20 years ago this July. Their commitment to the park and the love for the place, like you all here today, has allowed us to continue in our quest to create a park that's second to none. We actually feel blessed to be surrounded by such a wealth of people who are the friends of Barmoor. And finally, we sincerely hope that every time you drive through these gates, you will find peace, friendship, and happiness. John, will you please do us the honour of blessing the project? And so hopefully, by honouring the past, we prepare for the future.
Lord God, creator of all, we pray that all who pass through these gates in our time may find what they seek, be it peace, refuge, friendship, or rest. Bless these gates and those who enter with an awareness of the beauty of the world, with the joy of friendship shared, and with the peace found in you. We ask this in the name of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
In 2013 is the 500th anniversary of the Battle of Flodden. This seems particularly appropriate to have these gates open today, because there are going to be a lot of people come to this area, and we've got to remember that this was the site on Barmoor Estate in Barmoor Wood where the Earl of Surrey and his army encamped before the Battle of Flodden, and in fact came back the following day and encamped there again. And in contrast to the slaughter and mayhem of those days, we now find that the castle is a place of peace and quiet and friendship.
So on the morning of the 9th of September 1513, we know where the Scots were, Flodden Hill. We've been doing some digging there, some field walking, some metal detecting, and we know where the English were, Barmoor, in a field about 200 or 300 yards over in that direction. And we know that those are the two places that we can say on the battlefield for certain, this is where the armies were.
History oozes out of the ground here. This is a very evocative piece of land. This is where a bedraggled English army arrived late one evening in the pouring rain, not knowing what on earth was going to happen the following day. And yet we're on the brink, on the eve of a magnificent and unexpected victory. The English bill, a militarized version of an agricultural tool, is the motif that is used on the Barmoor gates. In fact, Stephen made this copy of the English bill. This is a direct copy of an original 1513 bill, which might have been at Flodden. And Stephen used this motif, this design, as part of the design for the gates.
Yeah, well, in the centre of the gate it features the bill hooks, which was one of the weapons used in the battle by the English, and also the cross, which is representing the cross that stands on the battlefield at Flodden. They also have the English rose there, and the Lamb of God, which is actually an emblem of peace. Some of the other weapons used, the arrows and swords. Also, I needed something to tie it all together, and I didn't want to put horizontal bars in it, so I thought about curving them, and then by a sort of coincidence it just looked like contour lines of a hill, so I thought I'd run with that idea. And finally, in the past couple of weeks, I've made the longbows, because they played a significant part in the battle. Put those on the pillars, because it's a prominent place for them to be situated.
£150 pull to £180 pull on that.
Out of sight,
I think listening to all of the speakers, that the customers' appetites are now whetted to what else can we do, what research can we get involved with and help the Remembering Flodden project. Who knows where this journey is going to go? This is exciting.